A couple of days ago, I got a message from a friend and they said, Brian, you got to check out Windows 11. And I'm scratching my head thinking, Windows 11? I haven't even heard about this. And sure enough, I went to research what had happened and someone had leaked the developer's copy of Windows 11 on the web. And I knew this was legit when I got a link to download it and the link had been taken down. So Microsoft isn't going to go around and take down links if that wasn't the legit thing. Anyway, we ended up getting a copy and we ended up trying to install it. And this is where the problems did start to happen, where you will need a TPM 2.0 module on your motherboard, or you will either need TPM on the AMD side of things, which you can activate in the BIOS via the option there with the CPU. Once either of these two conditions are met, you can then start to install Windows 11. And I gotta admit, first impressions are really good. It looks like a Windows 10.1 sort of thing, but the performance feels like it's really good. It almost feels like this developer copy of Windows 11 has all the crap, or most of the crap, taken away from the get-go, which is why I'm gonna be recommending if people can get on this copy as soon as they can, then they do that. Another thing as well is it looks like Windows 7, Windows 8.1, and Windows 10 Pro keys, they do work absolutely fine on this copy of Windows 11. However, if you guys wanna see a full installation tutorial on how to install Windows 11, do let us know in the comments section below. But in today's video, we are gonna be looking at the Windows 10 versus Windows 11 gaming performance and seeing how that stacks up and whether you should think about upgrading to this OS. Let's get onto it right after this sponsor spot.
Do you feel like this when you see this? Well, if so, you can get rid of that Windows activation message with today's video sponsor, SCD Keys, for as little as $12 USD. After you use that coupon BFTYC, you can get activated today. Links in the description below.
So the test bed that I decided to use here today was a 5950X from AMD. And this is on the ASRock Phantom Gaming X motherboard with the 6800 XT Taichi. Now the games that we're testing here, we're gonna drop them down to 1080p, lower settings, to really work that CPU and get the most FPS possible. And what I found here was with Windows 10, we'll pull up here first of all, F1 2020, was that we're getting 480 average FPS and the 1% and 0.1% lows were also really good too. And then we stepped over to Windows 11 and we were getting slightly higher FPS. It'd be to the tune of around 5% more FPS, which was looking very promising. And even though the OSs do feel similar, where we'll pull up the next example here, that's Shadow of the Tomb Raider, where I'll show you guys when I got to the end of the benchmark, it actually shows it as Windows 10 as another build. So as I was saying in the intro, it does look like Windows 11 is actually based off of Windows 10, but it's just a reskin. And also the features are pretty cool. But that being said, I believe this extra performance that you're seeing here in today's video could be due to the fact that it is a bit of a lighter weight version from the get-go, as I did test on a Windows 10 default copy. So I just reinstalled both Windows 10 and Windows 11 for this video. And what we can see with Shadow of the Tomb Raider was a very impressive result on Windows 11. I haven't actually seen my FPS this high in Shadow of the Tomb Raider before. We've got an average FPS on this benchmark of 223, and then the minimum FPS was 147. And then on Windows 10, we got 212 FPS and a very similar minimum score. Moving things over to Fortnite, this is the new update where you can fly UFOs. And I gotta say, flying the UFOs was actually pretty fun. While I was benchmarking this, I was like, you can fly a UFO? I was like, cool. So I started flying UFOs and I actually won a battle royale, as the tech yes man do. You know, even if it's against bots, I'll take that victory. And we got here 468 FPS on Windows 11 versus 455 on Windows 10. But on both these examples that I'm showing up here today, it's almost like the FPS was just too high. It's breaking this engine where the 1% and 0.1% lows were just actually really bad. So I wouldn't recommend taking your FPS this high on Fortnite, especially this new Alien update, where I have seen a lot better numbers in the past on those 1% and 0.1% lows. Then moving over to the final title we decided to test here, and this was CSGO, where we got the average FPS was coming in a similar ballpark on both sides. We got 520 on Windows 10 versus 528 on Windows 11. So we're just getting etching out 8 more FPS on Windows 11 side. Now, there was a trick that I had to do on CSGO. I looked around everywhere because I was like, damn, my FPS is looking pretty low, at least when I've benchmarked this game in the past. And I couldn't figure out why the FPS was this low. I mean, I tried this guy on Twitter posted up a fix that he was like log address or something in the console. I tried that, didn't work. But then I found what was working in CSGO, especially on low settings at 1080p, was the fact that the graphics card wasn't running its full potential. So I had to go into the AMD software and then up that minimum frequency to roughly 100% as well. And then that fixed the problem. Even upping it double the speed of what it is normally, because what was happening was the game wasn't demanding much graphical power at all. So the GPU was like falling asleep. And sometimes when the GPU falls asleep, you may notice in programs like GPU ID that it does show that it does change from PCIe 4 down to like PCIe 2 and PCIe 1 sometimes. And so I believe that can affect your FPS. So this raised the FPS up by quite a lot. And that might be a fix for you guys if you're having FPS problems in CSGO. And maybe not just CSGO for that matter, maybe other games like Minecraft or Valorant, for example, but that would fix that. And there it all is with Windows 11 versus Windows 10. I believe the performance gains we saw here today were just due to that developer copy being an actual better implementation of the OS rather than the standard Windows 10 that just comes with a lot of crap installed from the get-go. I mean, their latest update of Windows 10, they installed some weather bar, which I just was like, what is Microsoft doing? Why are they including a weather bar? No one asked for this, but sure enough, they put some extra, I'd call it bloatware, on the OS just to, who knows, maybe just confuse the end user. That's all I could take it as, because as soon as I saw this thing, I got rid of it. But speaking of getting rid of things, if you guys want to see a Windows 11 tutorial guide on how to decrapify Windows 11, then I can get that done on the channel, because Windows 10, I feel, is going to be at an end of an era. And then Windows 11, I definitely welcome the changes that they've done to this OS. It does look very polished, even with this developer copy, and it was running better for games. So I can give you guys a heap of content around this. If you want to see that, then be sure to smash that like button. Also, let us know in the comment section below, have you tried Windows 11 yet? Love reading those thoughts and opinions. As always, just like this question of the day here, which comes from California Thrills, and they ask, how do those front fans pull any air through? And they're talking about our custom build here that we did with the Corsair 500D. I did this with a fellow YouTuber, Designs by IFR, does amazing work. But basically this build right here, it pulls air because there's openings on both sides of the glass, and then it can pull air through there. And it does keep the build actually surprisingly cool for what would be considered a closed front on the case itself. Hope that answers that question. And if you guys have stayed this far and you're enjoying that Tech Yes content, then be sure to hit that sub button, ring that bell to get the content as soon as it drops. And I'll catch you guys in another tech video very soon. Peace out for now. Bye.